In the red, we have our Zerg player. He had a great showing.
Leave up for you.
He had a great showing in Season 3. Let's see if he can do better in this game. He's been having a tough time in Season 4 of Codex. Over here, our Protoss player from the Team Prime.
Any Pro Prime win.
Any Pro Prime. Oftentimes, when he's just like chilling around because his teammates are playing, or he's just going to a qualifier where he doesn't have to wear his uniform, wears very nice sweater jackets.
He does.
I always see him in very nice sweater jackets.
Man has class.
He does indeed.
Not classy enough to wear a blazer and a t-shirt, though.
No. He's not as classy as myself and you and
all I need is a pair
DJ Wheat and JP and your brother.
That's right. All we need is a pair of lensless hipster glasses, and we would just be, you know, there you go.
Ooh.
Ooh, you know. I'm like, I dress like a nerd, but I don't got the grades, you know?
Yep.
Yep.
Now, notice he has gone for the 9 pylon went down to Scout.
Oh man, that was close.
That's going to prompt a Nexus first build for any pro.
Which he will do right now. Uh-oh, but not if his drone's here.
And a drone actually beats a probe in a fight in this game because of the new healing mechanic on shields. So he's going to have to send another probe down.
Wouldn't it be funny if the,
well,
the drone ended
the
up...
the drone just pulled away, actually.
Oh, damn.
Yeah, I'm actually in shock and awe that any pro didn't know that the probe would lose and he pulled away so late. And that's the only thing going on the map. It's not actually that hard to do.
Yeah, that was a bit of an awkward situation.
He's actually making his forge tasteless and sending a second probe.
Oh my
might
god.
Might we see something really tricky?
Might we see some tomfoolery?
We may indeed.
He's got a cannon rush at the bottom of the ramp.
Oh my god.
I love it.
That's totally
cool. Love it.
That's why he let the probe die. And well, he probably didn't let it die on purpose, but that's why it died.
Drones are like, oh my god, what are these doing here?
And Leenok cancels. Both pylons get canceled, and suddenly any pro is like, ah, you should let me block your hatchery in the first place.
That's right. One cannon over here, and now the Nexus comes. Whoa, he's a lot of canceling. He misplaced the Nexus by a hex, had to cancel and replant it.
Yuck.
Yucky, yucky, yuck.
Yep. Leenok taking a funny second base, funny expansion on the side of the map. That may lead him to get aggressive since he's just so close to the rocks of any Pro Prime. Will the probe find it? Oh my god, Tasteless, will this probe find the expansion?
I spotted it.
Yeah, it did.
He saw it.
So
I was holding my breath there.
Not that that's going to change a whole lot of what any pro is going to do because, well, he's cannon expanding. He doesn't have any units to do anything with yet.
Well, he might do a quicker timing attack over there.
Certainly. Certainly.
In your opinion, what do you think about, you know, if let's just say this is a hypothetical. Let's think this out loud. Would you ever... If you're a Protoss and you saw a Zerg doing that, ever just immediately make 4 gates in your base and Zealot rush it, and then Cybernetics Core and Tech, because he's close. Save your Chrono Boost and the Tech kill the hatchery.
You know, he is close, but I would not do that in a match like this because it wouldn't be practiced.
I mean, theory-wise, because that's what I was just thinking. I'm like, I wonder if that would work if you just saved him with a few Chrono Boosts.
And just get a huge amount of Zealots out randomly.
Yeah, and just got them off rhythm.
It definitely has that surprise factor, so, it might. I haven't specifically tried the build, but I think it depends on will your opponent sniff that out, because normally against a cannon expand, you'd be like, oh, okay, like... LOL, there's not going to be any attacks for a while, so you just kind of drone up extra. So I think it could definitely work versus quite a few players. But if scouted right, they'd be like, nope. And I think they could stop it then.
So remember, guys, this is a very difficult position for Leenok to be in.
Yeah.
You got to be very careful.
Leenok, by the way, has 10 Zerglings now. Getting a third base up. any pro. Any pro doesn't really know what's going on yet, so he's playing quite safe. Has that cannon there already, as you see. Also has a few cannons above his ramp to be very safe.
That's good. You got to be safe, man.
Ooh, the Spire. I like this on this map. Okay.
Yeah, this is smart.
Nowadays, people are not really going Muta against Protoss so much because the timings are just, they're brutal to when Protoss actually hits you just with Warp Gate units. Or if they just go mass, Phoenixes. Anyways, he's going to go ahead and scout, see that there are going to be four Warp Gates. But as I was saying, I love it on this map because it's almost always cannon expansion. And the thing is, you can't really engage anywhere on this map with ground units against Colossus-based armies. The force field lanes are too short. The Colossuses are so good on this map. So to just take three bases, get a ton of gas, really work your economy, then take that fourth base quick as well, sometimes you can get this ridiculous number of Mutalisks, and just when they move out to attack you, you counter their main, do insane damage, then just try to whittle down their forces, because they're going to have to win with just one attack in that situation. So I love what Leenok is doing here.
Yeah, Leenok's a smart guy. By the way, he gooped. He did contaminate the gateway.
Ooh. And
now I have a question.
Yeah.
I'm only asking this because I haven't played Zerg in a little while. When something is contaminated, you don't actually have vision of it the entire time it's contaminated, right? You don't actually get vision of it, right? Okay.
So we do see it's going to be a very many gateway timing rush. Just a huge warp gate all in almost. Now, Leenok is going to have to figure this out pretty quickly and do everything in his power to stop it. I suggest a trillion billion sunken colony, or spine crawlers.
He doesn't really have cannons here to defend his expansions.
You see he's going to try to snipe out a stalker that's warping in. Blink is on the way. It's going to be a blink, maybe plus two or plus three timing rush.
Yeah, it's going to be mass stalker build.
Right now, 51 probes against 52 drones. And Leenok just has to get his gas up, make an unreal amount of mutas. And, well, he knows now that it's just mass warp gates because, well, he did scout again with that Overseer. So, knowing that it's going to be mass warp gates is, well, it's not like G.I. Joe where knowing's half the battle. It's maybe a fourth of the battle in CVP. You can assume there's going to be a huge amount of warp gates as soon as you start hitting with mutas. But he's just going to have to be very careful. Maybe a bunch of spine crawlers. Definitely a ridiculous amount of mutas.
So here we have the mutas just regrouping here. More stalkers being warped in here. They have blink. I wouldn't be surprised if they just blink over the rocks.
Yeah, looks like he's going to do that, Tasis.
He's doing it.
And actually, right now, these aren't going to do a whole lot. There are a couple spine crawlers, and there's a decent amount of speedlings and mutas out.
And the mutas are coming.
Blinking I don't away.
Know if he should have actually moved out with such a small number of stalkers. You really wanted to wait until he had more.
Blink does come up. He gets out of there.
I think he's actually cutting probes now. He's only going to make...
he's only at 54 probes.
Yeah.
Of course, it doesn't look like he even wants to take a third base at this point.
No, it's going to be a straight-up two-base timing push.
Mm. Oh, my.
Oh, nice. Getting some zealots over there.
Four drone kills over there.
And the stalkers are now moving out towards the base, I believe. Yes, they are.
I can't believe he's not bringing sentries.
Yeah, there's something weird going on here.
Good force field against Zerglings and Guardian Shield against Beetleist. He does have plus two attack. Looks like he wants to try to snipe stuff.
I think if he had stayed for another second, he could have sniped that.
Yeah. And here comes some Zerglings with the mutas. It's a good amount of mutas, about 18.
Nice.
Good force fields. Mutas definitely not want to attack into that. You know, that Guardian Shield is actually really great against Mutalisks. Leenok just keeps on pumping out units, making some more spine crawlers as well. Now, here's the thing. There's not any late game in what any pro is doing. We just have to have him have Leenok survive a bit longer here. Now, there are two attacks going on. The Muta's up there. The Stalker's hitting again at Leenok's expansion.
He's got the Stalker's over here. The Force Fields are in great position. And you are actually totally right about there's no late game investment here. He wants to win this with the Mass Stalkers. This is a pretty scary number of Mulisks, though.
It is indeed tasteless.
And the Lings are coming over here, too. I think our Zerg might actually manage to win this.
Yeah,
but we'll see.
You know, pure Stalker is not the way to do it. When I was talking about a Warp Gate Rush.
Unless you're Hagen, yeah.
No. I mean, if you want to max out and go, that can be okay, because Zergans don't get enough surface area on you. But just this weird, mediocre, medium amount that he's going with, not quite as good. Definitely Psystorm also helps against this build, I have to say.
And now the Spine Crawler is being remade. Zerg's actually going to go over here and attack. And actually, this might work, depending on these Stalkers' micro. He should not be blinking all these Stalkers back at once. He should blink the ones that are being shot at back.
Now,
one by one, two by two.
Yeah. Hurrah, hurrah.
Hurrah, hurrah.
Tasteless. It looks like Leenok is going to be almost unstoppable here. It's 91 supply to 146. Leenok in the lead. Some Zealots coming in. Too little, too late. And these Mutas are going to be able to just crush through so many Stalkers.
And that's it. That, I believe, is game.
Yep,
GG.
Any Pro Prime takes the last slot. And Leenok Foyu going to have two chances to stay in Code S. Any Pro who said none of the fearsome players are in his group, not.
Leenok, cute guy. Looks like a koala bear. I love him. Got that koala bear adorable look to him.
Yeah.
He's a young guy, man.
He is a young guy.
And, you know, he's taking on these older pros. It's impressive. Crushing defeat there for any pro.
Yeah. Especially after acting like he was a big shot.
I know.
Losing all his games.
Yeah.
He was a big shot now.
He was all like, I'm the man. I'm the man.
Yeah. Look at me. I'm the man.
Look at me. He was doing this with his fingers.
Yeah, he was.
But not anymore.
Now he's doing this with his fingers.
Like that. So, we have more games tomorrow here at the GSL.
We do.
Tomorrow
indeed.
Is Friday.
Is it? I don't even know what day of the week is.
Yeah, today's Thursday because
like
I had to work elsewhere this morning. So that's the day I have some voice acting stuff, which is why I'm so out of it right now. So, we have some more games Friday. And it should be
Saturday
awesome.
Saturday we have games.
Saturday
well.
We got Code A games. So keep on tuning in, guys. You don't need to go out at all.
No,
just
don't
stay
leave the
at
house.
Home. Don't leave the house. Lock the doors. Close the blinds. Okay.
Yeah. You need food. Have your mom go get it at the grocery store. Maybe order Domino's pizza. You can make pizzas online.
Domino's has changed
at Domino's.
The recipe in the past 6 months, and it is much better.
Really?
It's
no longer the really thick bready pizza.
I know they changed whatever. They changed the bread. I believe they changed everything.
Really?
Yeah, because they did polls and they found out that actually the pizzas. We're not selling. Well, if they were selling, but people only bought them because of their efficiency and the delivery and stuff, they don't actually taste good. So,
yeah, that's
store
that's
up some food
true.
For the GSL. And we got more and more games coming up here. Thanks to our sponsors at Sony Ericsson. We love you guys. Thank you guys at home for joining us. You guys are great. Thanks,
you guys
Blizzard,
awesome,
for making
actually.
Such a great game.
And I love StarCraft fans.
I love them.
And by loving StarCraft fans, I love myself, Tasteless.
I there you go.
Because I'm a StarCraft
wow.
fan.
Now, I probably will not have the shiny blazer on today. We should have my blazer clean, which means I will actually have sleeves that fit. I have very
That's
long
good.
Arms. I should have been a swimmer.
You look like such a chimp
I
right
get
now.
Very good hugs. Let's look at the results for today's matches.
Yeah, and NSP Genius absolutely destroyed the group, outplayed everyone by far in first place. StarTales Rainbow gets second. No big surprise there. Leenok Foyu in third. AnyPro Prime.Wii gets absolutely manhandled in pretty much every single game. He got manhandled. So, sorry about that, AnyPro. Good player, but
tough
a step
group.
Below this group. Yeah, this group was absolutely stacked to the hilt.
Tomorrow's matches will cast Friday night here in
Ooh.
Korea. OGS MC versus OGS Nada. Oh, damn.
Yep. And then OGS Inca against Sun Zenith. Any guesses, Tasis, as to who will get last place in that group?
I just have no clue. I'm just going to have to make a wheel at home with the four of them and spin it.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, no, not really, but it might be a tough series for San Zenith, our player who actually blocked off his own pass expansion with his own pylon. Hopefully he's improved. This is going to be the group from hell for him. MC, Nada, and Inca, this is a very tough group. Three OGSs. OGS, a very tough StarCraft II team. A
lot of OGs in that group, Tasteless.
Yeah, a lot of OGSs. Now, Artosis, we did it. Good job today. You were great.
Thanks.
Hey, Artosis, you were great back there, man. Way to go.
Wow. You were great support for me, Tasteless.
Thank you.
I couldn't have done it as great as I did it if you didn't do it as well as you did.
Please tell your friends to tune in to GOM TV. Spread the word.
Yeah.
If you ever want to come out to the studio, it's free to come in here. Just like our streaming's free, you can come over. High five, John the translator.
That's right. He loves high fives.
He's good at high fives.
John
not
loves
too hard,
high five
not too wimpy.
He's just nervous at first because he's like, are they playing a trick on me? I love to high five. But he does.
So we're close to wrapping it up, guys. The Code A match is tomorrow. Let's get that up there first.
July Zerg from Sartail going up against the Huck Killer, Odin MVP, Zenix Guardian against Slayer's Yu-Gi-Oh! I believe that's Golden Foyu. I will check into that. So a couple decent matches, ZBT and ZBZ. Make sure you join us for those. Started our usual time. And, that's Code A, that's Code S. And all that's left, Tasteless, are the interviews.
Interview time.
I hope John picked out some excellent questions from the GOMTV.net forums. Guys, remember to leave questions. John goes through them. If you spam, he's going to lock you out. So
that's right. You're going to be out in the cold.
That's right.
You don't want to be out in the cold.
Yeah, you're going to be looking, reading all the questions. Like, oh, I have a great question.
I just wish you would pick mine. But you shouldn't have spammed it. So, guys, thank you again for joining us. For Tasteless and Artosis, Tasteless here at GOMTV. Again, please spread the word so we get as many viewers
spread
as possible.
Spread the word like it's creep.
We improved our stream, so we've been getting positive feedback on that. If you're having trouble with people in different parts of the world, let them know. But we got to go. That's all the time we have. So I'll see you guys tomorrow. Enjoy the interviews.